So that's one woe. Now we come to the last two trumpets, which are the two more woes. And we're told that the sixth angel sounds, and he sees four more angels appear at the Euphrates. Now this is interesting. It says the Euphrates, that's a particular area which is now in Iraq. Although many of these things are on a global scale, we see here that there are specific things happening in the Middle East, things to do with Israel. And the focus of the end times is very much on the land of Israel. And we'll see that in particular with Armageddon, which only happens in Israel. And so therefore, you know, we don't want to think that necessarily everything is global. There are some local events, some particular events which are happening. All right. Now, what's very significant is that we learn here that these six trumpets have been, sorry, these four angels have been given power to kill a third of mankind. Now, let's just do some numbers here. Given that at the moment, the Earth's population is 8 billion, during the seals, we've heard that a quarter of the world's population was destroyed or taken away. So therefore, that takes it down by 2 billion to 6 billion. So at the beginning of the trumpets, as far as we know, there's just 6 billion people. Now another third is taken. A third of six is two. So another 2 billion people have been killed. We started off with 8 billion. We're down to 6, and now another 2 billion are taken, which means that now we have a population of only 4 billion people. That is 50% of the world's population has gone. All right. Now, this is very significant. Okay. So often I hear people, they see something on the news about earthquakes, and they say, oh, it's an earthquake, it's the end times. Listen, we're looking for things on a whole new scale. The earthquakes that I've seen on the news really don't match the description that we'll see later on. It says, in fact, there's an earthquake greater than ever before, and we'll talk about that when we come to it. Also, we're just not seeing that kind of scale. In fact, statistically, did you know that earthquakes have actually decreased very slightly in the last 100 years? We see more of it because we have the internet, we have the news, we have social media, and we see so much more of it, and things are filmed where they weren't filmed before. Perhaps before there would have been an earthquake and we'd never even hear about it. And now we hear about it all the time, and so people have got the impression that there's an increase in earthquakes, but actually there's really not. And what's very telling is that here, in spite of having half the population removed, it still says that men do not repent. You know, the idea that there's a revival during this time is just not there. There will be people saved, I'm sure. But it says here that, generally speaking, men just refuse to repent. And the whole idea of the tribulation saints is out the window. It contradicts scripture. It really does. In fact, I've heard people who believe in the tribulation saints, who believe that, you know, we as a church will be raptured before these things happen, and then during what they call the tribulation, as I've said, that's the wrong name, but what they call the tribulation, then there'll be this big revival and a bunch of people will be saved. I just don't see it. And even their own teachers, and I've heard two or three of them say it, they've said, have you heard the latest that when you all disappear, meaning the Christians disappear, then we'll all know to become Christians, we'll become believers. Listen, if you can't go on with the Lord while everything's all right now, how on earth are you going to do it when everything's going mad? Well, you know, that's true. I think that that's reasonable thinking. I think that's correct thinking. But you need to realize that the conclusion of that is tribulation saints is just not happening. It's just not going to be realistic. Because as you say, they're not going to go on with the Lord. With no one to teach them, no mature Christians around to strengthen them, it's just not going to happen. And we need to take that to heart. Now let's look. We've got the six seals. They're described in Revelation chapter 6. We've had the explanation, which we found in Revelation chapter 7. And then we come to the seventh seal, which is indeed the seven trumpets. And we've covered the first six trumpets so far, in chapters 8 and 9, there it's quite clear, but then there's more explanation after the sixth trumpet. Okay, and this covers two chapters. In fact, it covers about half a dozen chapters, because chapters 10 and 11, then the seventh trumpet is actually mentioned in Revelation 11 verse 15, but actually we don't see the results of that trumpet until Revelation 16. So really, from Revelation 10 until Revelation 16, it's the explanation of what's happened in the trumpets. It's talking about the other events which are happening around that. It's talking about the things which are going on in the heavenlies. It's talking about the battles that are going on and around. And so they're very important chapters. However, because this study is just about the timeline, I'm going to skip over that, and we're going to go straight to the seventh trumpet and the bowls. Okay. Now, there are a couple of things that I do want to highlight. Revelation 10 verse 4 is very interesting. It says that there are seven thunders, but they're sealed up, so we're just not told what they are. Now, how you fit those into a timeline, I'm not quite sure. Okay, it could be that actually the seventh trumpet is the seven thunders, but we're not told what they are, and then the seventh thunder is the seven bowls. That's a possibility, and that's something that you need to bear in mind. I'm just not going to put the thunders into my chart because we're not given any details about them. Okay, Revelation 10 verse 7 is also interesting. It's rather puzzling. It says that in the days of the sounding of the seventh angel, okay, so during the seventh trumpet, when he is about to sound, the mystery of God would be finished or fulfilled, as he declared to his servants the prophets. What is the mystery? Could it be from Corinthians, where it talks, I tell you a mystery, we will all be changed in the twinkling of an eye? Could be that. Or could it be the mystery that Gentiles would be co-heirs with Israel? Now that fits more with being declared by his servants the prophets, if that's talking about Old Testament prophets, not New Testament, but Old Testament, which would be the assumption when you say prophets. So is it talking about the fact that, you know, these Gentiles would be joined with Israel as we are, you know, in the plan of God? It's interesting. Anyway, I'm not going to say much more about that, but I just throw that out there because I want you to think, and I want you to search beyond this study and start to think, what could those things be? But let's have a look at Revelation 11 also, where the seventh trumpet actually is sounded. Okay, we see here that there's a declaration that the kingdoms of this world have become the kingdoms of our Lord and his Christ, and he shall reign forever and ever. And it kind of infers that Jesus has come back, that Jesus is on earth and he's taken over. It's only an inference, it's not a clear statement, but it's an interesting one. And also, again, at the seventh seal, at the seventh trumpet, and at the seventh bowl, we see there's lightning noises, thunderings, and an earthquake. All right, and we see those in those other verses, and we need to bear those things in mind, because again, it's an indication that actually the seventh seal, seventh trumpet, and seventh bowl may happen at the same time.